Hi, I'm Piers and I'm a software engineer on the SQL Monitor team here at Redgate. I'm delighted to be able to show you the new features in SQL Monitor 9 to help with large or hybrid estates. We're going to start with the new estate pages in SQL Monitor 9. These pages are to help you proactively manage your entire estate so you can get an overview of the current state without having to collect and manipulate the data yourself. These pages give you an overview and help you identify where to focus your efforts, as well as then provide drill downs for the additional data you need. Let's take a look at each of these pages so we can show you how they can really help. The versions page lets you keep track of the SQL Server installations in your estate, ensuring that they are fully updated and making it easy to download the latest update for each individual SQL Server instance. This helps you easily get all of the security updates from Microsoft, and the current state can be exported for audit or compliance purposes. The disk usage page helps you to manage the storage your servers rely on. Running out of storage is a nightmare, so this page provides predictions for future use, helping you to proactively plan hardware upgrades in time. While the entire estate may have enough capacity, individual disks could be at risk of filling, so SQL Monitor 9 provides a prediction for each disk of when it will fill up, as well as a clearly visible warning if it will exceed its capacity in the next year. You can also drill down to individual disks to see more information, including the usage for the individual files, so you can identify what's causing disks to fill up. The backups page helps you to ensure that you know your estate is being backed up appropriately and that the backups are succeeding, helping you meet your recovery point objectives. You can track your current position to see how much data you would lose if a disaster occurred now. If you want more detail about an individual database, you can get historical data about backups as well as the worst RPO experienced in the past 30 days. The jobs page helps you get an overview of the SQL agent jobs running in your estate, so you can check that all your important jobs are succeeding and which jobs have failed. Further down, you can dive into diagnosing those failures with a full execution history and error messages present. You can even jump to the correct overview at the time the job failed by clicking here. For those with a hybrid estate, the ability to monitor Azure SQL servers is critical. With support for Azure SQL databases, you'll be able to keep an eye on your on-premises and cloud systems on a single pane of glass. One of the new features of SQL Monitor 9 is the support of Azure SQL databases and Elastic Pools. Here on the overview page of an Elastic Pool, you are presented with Azure-specific metrics, such as the pool's DTU. These will help you to ensure that you are on the right service tier, avoiding outages or wasted money. Further down the overview, you can monitor the worker thread usage and the session usage, as well as the storage currently being used by the pool. At the bottom of the overview is a list of the databases that are currently in the pool. This will give you an idea of how the databases fit together. You can expand these for more information and optionally go to its overview page. Here, just like with your on-premises servers, you can access a vast array of information for diagnostic purposes. Azure entities are also shown on SQL Monitor's dashboard with Elastic Pools and Azure SQL databases appearing side by side with on-premises servers. You get alert warnings and sparkline graphs to help you quickly see issues across your entire hybrid estate. Try these great new features on our online demo or download your free trial at redgate.com. If you have any questions or suggestions, please get in touch to speak to one of our SQL Monitor specialists.